Hi, Mike.
Hello.
So we have another question from a student again.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. And then can you read the question for me, please?
Okay. So here it is. I would like my kid to attend summer school abroad in the near future. And I want to improve my English skills to be able to communicate with local teachers. I'm thinking of doing a lot of reading and listening for my self-study, and I'd like to know what kind of material or content is appropriate and effective for my purpose. Should they be something related to education or school? Yes, so okay. That's the inquiry.
Okay, all right, thank you. So that's a good idea to take your kids to a summer school in a foreign country. I know a lot of people who do this. Anyway, So what's your take? What should this mom or dad be listening to for his or her self-study before they go off to study abroad?
Yeah, so at first, he or she should consider those interests that she's interested to deal with. Yes, so because there are a lot actually of reading and listening materials, but it all depends on the interest of the student who would like to improve in these skills. Yes, so that's what I could have for him or her in this case.
I agree. You can't listen to something you're not even interested.
Yeah.
If she's interested in education stuff or school stuff, sure. But if not, you can't listen to that every day.
That won't actually be effective because one of the factors that would actually take place is to sustain. Yes, so it's even hard to sustain if you're reading or listening to something that you're not interested in. Yeah,
exactly. You start looking for an excuse to stop.
Yeah, of course.
I know I would. So I guess we agree that this person should just listen or read whatever she wants, basically.
Yeah.
Yeah. And it's true that good books that you enjoy, you get sucked into. You don't know one to tell you to stop. You just read, you know?
You can put it down.
Yeah. But stuff that you're not interested, you can't read.
Just seconds. Done.
Yeah. You'll be flipping page only, pages so far, you know. So, you don't want to. All right. So, next up, what I was thinking was what she should be doing in order to prep herself for a trip like this is to prepare for in case of emergency. She's worried about talking to the local teacher. Sure, that's important. I would say take daily conversation lessons with us. We have
class. Exactly. Yeah. So of course, the thing is this, he or she needs to communicate with the local teachers. Yes. So of course, the speaking skill is totally important. So as for me, this person, I highly recommend this person to really attend classes at Brightshare. Yes, so because here at Brightshare, there are we have here the four skills. Yes, so and of course, speaking skill is actually one because it could be possible that this person will be having this conference. And then, of course, English language is mostly the medium of instruction or medium of communication, rather. Right. So, I highly recommend this person to do this. Yeah.
Yeah. And then lastly, I would say prepare for emergency. Like I said, stuff can happen. Right? Maybe kids get sick or injured. Mm-hmm. Now what, right? And then you take your kid to a hospital and you want to be able to explain what happened, how she's feeling and all that stuff. And that's something this person really needs to prep for. And to do that, of course, you can't memorize every medical term, but at least I would say be proficient enough to explain you the symptom that you're having and what your kid is having, and then like know just like bare minimum medical terms, right?
Yeah.
Or maybe just create cheat sheet just in case.
Yeah. That helps. That helps. Yeah. Yeah. Exactly.
Because you may never need them, but just in case if you need it, there's something you can just flip through and say, you know.
You can refer to when the need arises.
Yeah. Okay. I think that's kind of it then. I will see if I can just wrap this up. So number one is to listen or read whatever this person enjoy the most.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah, because you can't read something you don't enjoy. You just can't. You can't sustain every day, right?
So couldn't agree more.
Yep. Number two, practice speaking as well, because you will have to speak, right?
Exactly.
And we recommend that you take a lesson with us, but you know, find the opportunities to practice your speaking skills, and that would be good. Mm-hmm. And then lastly, prepare for emergency.
Prepare for the unexpected.
Things can happen. And like, you know, in this pandemic age, you never know what's going to happen. Maybe your kid or yourself may catch a new variant of COVID. And then now what, right?
Yeah.
You don't want to be freaking out at the hospital. That would be good. Okay. Anything to add?
Well, actually, I'm just also like wondering, like, before this will be done, like, because this person actually had this question, like, should they be related, or should they be something related to education or school? Yeah, so, well, of course, like, I can say, like, aside from the interest that this person is in, reading some education-related stuff is also highly recommended. Because, like, regarding the trend of education today, it's kind of different from the ones in the past. And then for this person to get updated, then I think, like, this one is also a nice thing to deal with, education-related articles.
But I would say if you're going to do that, like wait until you're comfortable listening and reading English, then get into stuff that are not particularly your interest, but you have to cover, right?
Exactly. I agree also with that.
Non-starters education and school related stuff, because then you'd be like, I don't want to do this anymore, right?
Yeah, so when that goal of him or her primarily is achieved, then I could say he could deal with something else. Yeah, and that could be related to this.
Yeah. Okay, I think that wraps it up. All right. Well, thank you so much for your time.
Appreciate it. Yes.
All right, so good to see you. And then for our viewers, if you like what you just watched, click the like and also subscribe to our channel. And then we'll see you guys again soon. All right, bye.
Bye-bye.